If you have young children in your family, I'm sure that they must watch a show called Shindig, and I'm sure that if you have seen it with them, then you've got to know this next young man, Mr. Glen Campbell. Welcome to you.
McGoffin, buddy.
Oh, really?
Once.
Yes. Yeah, Frank was telling me something interesting about you, but I found out something also, Glenn, is that you made a couple of records in the country and western field
that
were big, big hits, and then suddenly you decided to go in the other direction. What about your fans that you had acquired in the other field? What did they say about that?
Well, they said boo.
Really?
They didn't like it too much.
Tell him some of the, Glenn, before he really started to get going into his own career, he did a lot of demonstration records for a lot of big stars. Who are some of the people you've made?
I did a lot for Ricky Nelson and Elvis Presley. In fact, I did the
you
dub
did
on...
You did some for Elvis Presley?
Yeah!
What's he like?
Oh, he's a great guy. He really is. I did the dub on...
He can afford to be so darn rich.
When I did the demo on Do the Crab, I said, no, he won't record that. But he did, and it was a hit record.
Did you write the song?
No, Ben Weissman.
Uh-huh. This is kind of new for you, this instrument.
Yes, it is.
How long have you been at that?
About 8 or 9 months.
I love this song. Would you like to hear a little banjo solo? Glen Campbell? Oh, it's
out of tune. Y'all ready? This is the Beverly Hillbillies thing. I was doing an album with the Kingston Trio at the Hungry Eye, and when I got through, I was so fascinated with this instrument. Well, I have been all my life, but just didn't take the time to learn to play it. And John Stewart of the Kingston Trio gave me a brand new banjo, said, here, learn how to play it.
Hey, what's it like being a teenage idol? Is it dangerous? Frankie would know about this, too. Is it bad? Have you ever had... What do they do to you as kids when they finally catch up to you? Because, boy, they go crazy when they see you guys perform.
I toured with the Beach Boys for about 6 months and taken one of the guys' places. I was staying home writing an album and doing a new album.
Mm-hmm.
And I lost two watches, most of my hair, and three or four shirts.
They tear your hair out?
Yeah, they give me some hair, you know, give me a finger, you know, or something like that.
Next time we see you, you might look like Yul Brynner. What's your next song, Dan?
Universal Soldier, my new record.
It's going to be a big hit, too, they say.
I hope so, yes.
Where are you from? What part of the country?
Arkansas, originally.
Yeah,
Hillbilly country.
Yeah.
So we're here.
Universal Soldier.
Right.
New record by
Brand
this
new.
Young man.
If
Glen,
I
take off.
He's 5 foot two, and he's 6 feet four. He fights with missiles and with spears. He's all of 31, and he's only 17. He's been a soldier for 1,000 years. He's a Catholic, a Hindu, an atheist, a Jain, a Buddhist, a Baptist, and a Jew. He knows he shouldn't kill, but he knows he always will kill you, my friend, for me and me for you. He's fighting for Canada, he's fighting for France, he's fighting for the USA. He's fighting for the Russians and he's fighting for Japan, and he thinks he'll put an end to war that way. He's fighting for democracy, he's fighting for the Reds, he says it's for the peace of all. He's the one who must decide who's to live and who's to die, and he never sees the writing on the wall. But without him, how could Hitler have condemned him at the cow? Without him, Caesar would have stood alone. He's the one who gives his body as a weapon of the war, and without him, all this killing can't go on. Yes, he's the universal soldier, and he really is to blame. His orders come from far away no more. They come from him and you and me. And brothers, can't you see? This is not the way we...